The Prophet ﷺ, at times he would also stand and drink, but his noble sunnah was to sit and drink. At this particular occasion, he saw this container hanging in the house of Sulaim, so he approached it and he drank from it straight away. Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu, what does he say? After the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam drank from this container, what did Sulaim do? She went over to the container and she cut the mouth of the container and took it. She cut the mouth of the container and she took it. I.e. the place where water is poured from, the end of the container, she cut it and she took it. And she was asked, why did you do this? And she said, I've taken this off and I'll save it in my house and take tabarruk and blessings from it. Why? Because the blessed mouth of the Prophet ﷺ touched it. You see how the Sahaba, they were so eager to preserve and keep with them anything that had touched the Prophet ﷺ. So she cut the mouth of this container and she kept it for herself, radiallahu anha, in her house. As for the Sahaba radiallahu anhum taking blessings from the blessed saliva of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi which was within his blessed mouth sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Shaykh Abdullah Sirajuddin radiallahu anhu says, كان صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا بصق على مريض أو نفس أو تفل على موضع مرضه برئ المريض وشفي بإذن الله تعالى. He said radiallahu anhu that if the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ever placed his saliva, or ever blew, or ever sprinkled his blessed saliva over an ill person, that ill person would instantly be cured with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, this occurred for many of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. And then he mentions to us these occasions when the miraculous blessed saliva from the mouth of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cured people. And he said from that is the occasion when Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, his eye had an infection. He had an eye infection. And he said that Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim radiallahu anhuma both narrate again from the authority of Sayyidina Sahal ibn Sa'ad radiallahu anhu, who said, on the day of Khaybar, in the battle of Khaybar, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَأُعْطِيَنَّ الرَّايَةَ غَدًا رَجُلًا يَفْتَحُ اللَّهُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُهُ يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيُحِبُّهُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said on the day of Khaybar, he said, tomorrow I shall give this flag, the flag of Islam, to a man at whose hands Allah will give victory. At whose hands Allah will give victory. He loves Allah and His Messenger, and Allah and His Messenger love him. Now all of the Sahaba became excited. Each and every Sahabi wanted themselves to be that person who the Prophet ﷺ gave so many glad tidings for. The glad tiding of Islam being given victory at that person's hand, the glad tiding of that person loving Allah and His Messenger, and the greatest glad tiding that Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam love that person. Sayyidina Sahal said, فَلَمَّا أَصْبَحَ النَّاسِ غَدَوْا عَلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ وَسَلَّمُ وَكُلُّهُمْ يَرْجُوا أَنْ يُعْطَاهَا. When the morning came, all of the Sahaba rushed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wishing that they, each and every one of them, was that particular individual who would be given the flag. The Prophet ﷺ looked around and he said, Aina Ali ibn Abi Talib? Where is Ali, the son of Abu Talib? And the Sahaba said, Huwa yashtaki aynahu. He has an infection in his eye, Ya Rasulullah. And the Prophet ﷺ said, bring him to me. Bring him to me. So Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu was brought to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَبَصَقَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فِي عَيْنِهِ فَبَرِئَ كَأَنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ بِهِ وَجَعْهُ. He was brought to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Messenger of Allah placed his saliva in the eye of Sayyidina Ali, and it was cured instantly as if it never was infected. It was cured instantly as if it was never infected before that. رَضِيَ anhu. And likewise, he said, one of the companions whose name was Salama, Salama radiallahu anhu again on the day of Khaybar. Again on the day of Khaybar, Salama radiallahu anhu broke his leg. Salama radiallahu anhu broke his leg on the day of Khaybar. He came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam nafasa fiya thalatha nafasatin fi mashtakaytuha fa mashtakaytuha hatta as-sa'a. He said, I came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with my broken leg, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam blew over my leg 3 times from his blessed mouth sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, from that day I never complained about my leg ever again. He said, from that day I never complained about my leg ever.